One last interesting thing around where. You might recall that when we were taking a look at select statements, we could add in calculated columns. So an example of that was to do something like select name population divided by area, and we might rename that to something like population density, and we were pulling all that data from cities. If we ran this, we then saw the population density for each individual city. We can do the same kind of calculation inside of where statements as well. We are not restricted to just doing checks against existing columns inside of our table. So for example, let's try to find a list of all the different cities that have a population density greater than 6,000. To do so, I'm going to remove that semicolon on the very end. I'm going to add in a where clause. And inside of here, I will find population divided by area, and then put in greater than 6,000, like so. Now, I want you to take consideration of the order of operations here. There's two ways that we could possibly evaluate this. It could either be understood as first do population divided by area, and then make sure the result of that is greater than 6,000. The other possibility might be something like check and see if area itself is greater than 6,000. Well, the order of operations here is to do all the mathematical stuff first. We're going to first find the result of population divided by area, and then check to see if that is greater than 6,000. So if we run this now, we're probably going to see a result of only Delhi and Sao Paulo. Because looking at our last query's output right here, it looks like Tokyo and Shanghai have a lower than 6,000 population density. So I'm going to run this, and sure enough, yep, Delhi and Sao Paulo. Okay, so again, inside of these where clauses, we can add in as many mathematical operations or even string operations as we want. We can use all those different operators we spoke about a couple of videos ago.